Hello guys, in this video tutorial I will be talking about getting started with Simulink. So Simulink is a model based design environment which is integrated with MATLAB. It is a great way to design systems as you can clearly visualize what is happening in your system. It is kind of an add-on to MATLAB. Suppose you have a system which integrates your input and gives you an output A. In order to perform this system in MATLAB, you have two ways. Either you can use command window or M file and write a bunch of line of code to perform your system, or you can use Simulink. In Simulink, you will divide each element of the system into blocks. You will connect your blocks and you can directly see what will be the output of the system. Now let's see how it actually works in Simulink. To create a new Simulink model, click on this new button here and select Simulink model. A blank screen will pop up which will work as your workspace area for Simulink. In order to build a system, click on this library browser here. And here you will see a bunch of blocks are here, which will be used according to the need of system. For instance, commonly used blocks. In commonly used blocks, you can see there is a block for constant values of the system. Similarly, there are blocks for gain and there are blocks for scope. Scope is used to observe the waveform of your system. In this tutorial, we will build a Simulink model to find the step response of a second order transfer function. For those who don't know what a transfer function is, it is the ratio of output to the input of a system in Laplace domain. If the input and transfer function for a system is known, we can easily calculate what will be the output of system. In order to build it in Simulink, click on this library browser and search for the block called transfer function. Here you can see the block is transfer function, simply drag and drop it. Now search for the block called step. This is block for step, simply drag and drop it. Now search for the block for scope. Scope is used to observe the waveform. After importing these blocks to the workspace area, just simply connect all these blocks with the help of lines. To modify the parameters of a particular block, double click on that block and here you can see the parameters are numerator coefficients and denominator coefficients. For a second order transfer function, we change these parameters to 1, 2 and 4. And as you can see, the transfer function is now changed to 1 upon s square plus 2s plus 4. Now if we double click the block step, we can see the step time is 1, initial value is 0 and final value is 1. What it means is, when time is equal to 1, step goes from 0 to 1, which is fine. Now set the simulation time for which you want to run the simulation and hit the run simulation button. To observe the waveform, double click the block scope. And here you can see the output waveform for a step response of a second order transfer function. So guys, this was a simple example of getting started with Simulink. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. If you have any suggestions for us, please let us know in the comment section below. And for more cool tutorials like this, subscribe to our channel and visit matlabhelper.com. Thank you.